Hi, I'm attorney Manny Serra. I'm a partner at the Rossen Law Firm, and we're here for you when bad things happen to good people. So another commonly asked question is, if I pass the breathalyzer, will I be let go? Meaning if I blow into the breathalyzer and it shows triple zeros or below the legal limit, which is 0.08, is an officer gonna let me go? And the answer is no. In the state of Florida, an officer cannot let you go if he makes a determination that there is enough probable cause to believe that you are driving a vehicle while impaired under the influence of an alcohol and or chemically controlled substance. He or she is going to arrest you and ask you to provide a breath sample. If you deny that breath sample, he or she is still going to arrest you because they cannot unarrest you. If you provide the breath sample, the same is true. He or she cannot unarrest you. In fact, if you blow triple zeros or below the legal limit, it's not uncommon to see an officer ask you then for a urine sample to test whether there's maybe some cannabis in your system, some opioids, some cocaine. That's when they kind of pin the tail on the donkey, right? They go, oh, let's get this breath test. Oh, it's triple zeros, it's below the legal limit. Let's ask him for some urine. For an officer to do that, there actually has to be some suspicion of drug use. So it's a field day in court when they do those things. So to get back to the question, will an officer unarrest me or let me go if I blow triple zeros or pass the breathalyzer or below a 0.08? The answer is no, you are arrested. And in fact, you have to spend around a minimum of 8 hours in jail to detox for them to just be able to cover their own butt in terms of having alleged impaired people, intoxicated people in the jail. You have to sober up before they let you out. So it's not like you get arrested, a bond's made, and you're out within 2-3 hours. Unfortunately, you may be sitting in there for quite a bit. The breathalyzer is something that the state attorney uses for courtroom presentation for evidence to condemn you rather than to let you off the hook. So if you provide a urine sample or even a blood sample, if you say, I'd rather do a blood sample, you'd have to pay for it on your own account unless the officer asks for a blood sample, which is very rare. But a urine or blood sample, they're still gonna arrest you. They have to wait for those results to come back, meaning they have to send it to the lab, the lab has to give out the reading, and then there has to be a medical examiner or someone at the medical examiner's office or the lab who reviews the results and then makes a determination as to what was in your system at that time. So you're not gonna get unarrested or let go if you provide a urine sample or a blood sample on scene. If they, meaning the state attorney, gets the blood results, the breath results, and or the urine results, and they show as clean, right? They show that you were not impaired. A lot of times that office of the state attorney will null pros or no file or no info the case, just depending at the stage of where the case is. What happens after arrest, believe it or not, is that your case goes into a pre-filing division at the state attorney's office, where they then collect the evidence that was collected against you, review that evidence, and then make a filing decision on your case. A lot of times during that pre-filing stage, we're in contact with the state attorney because after someone gets arrested, they hire us to look into it for them, to help with some DMV issues maybe that may come along with the DUI, because there are DMV issues that come along with the DUI. You need to hire a lawyer within 10 days if you've been arrested for DUI. That's a side note, guys. But we can then talk with the state attorney's office and say, hey, look, we reviewed these results, or have you reviewed the results? It doesn't look like my client was impaired in any which way. Your officer made a wrong decision. He made a mistake. And we all make mistakes, especially at work, we make mistakes. So understand that if you do blow below the legal limit, if you do provide a urine sample that is clean or a blood sample that is clean, you aren't gonna get unarrested. But the best thing that could happen after that is that the state attorney makes a decision not to pursue charges against you. But unfortunately, you do have the arrest on your record and you do have a police report that would be public record as to the arrest. So you would wanna expunge that off of your record.